3D screen effect. With your screen recording on the timeline, go to the Fusion page, select the media in one, hit shift spacebar, type in DVE and add the DVE node. With the DVE one selected, adjust the C move, adjust the X rotation and the Y rotation. Ink drop. Drag an ink drop effect on top of your clip, then go to the inspector and change the composite mode to screen. Super slow-mo. Select the clip that you want to slow down, hit Command and R to bring up the retime controls, then select the drop down, change speed 25%. Then go to your inspector, scroll down until you see retime and scaling, change the retime process to optical flow, change the motion estimation to speed warp. Camera shake. Make boring titles look better. Select the text one, hit shift spacebar and type in camera shake and click on add. With the camera shake one, reduce the X deviation just a bit and the Y deviation just a bit. And then reduce the overall strength quite a bit and the speed. Sky replacement. Place the clip where you want to replace the sky on video layer number two. Place the sky that you want to be visible on video layer number one. Then go to your effects library, search for 3D keyer, drag the 3D keyer onto video layer number two, and then change your viewer to open effects overlay. Then go to your effects and start painting the sky. Under matte finesse, give it some clean blacks to get rid of those harsh edges. Speed ramp transition. Right click on the first clip, select retime controls. Right click again, select retime curve. Right click on the second clip, select retime controls. Right click again, select retime curve. Then open the dropdown on both clips where it says retime frame and change that to retime speed. Deselect retime frame. Do this on the second clip as well. Then go to the point where you want the speed ramping to start. Create a speed point, then drag up the right line on the first clip to around 1000%. Then select the speed point and choose the smooth button. This will make it a smooth curve. Then bring back the second clip to match the first clip. Go to the point in time where you want the speed ramping to end. Create another speed point. Now drag up the left line to around 1000%. Select the speed point and smooth it out. Then go to your effects library, grab an adjustment clip and put it on top of both clips and make it the size of your speed ramping. Go to open effects, choose the directional blur or the zoom blur, drag it on top of the adjustment clip. Then go to the first frame of the adjustment clip, set a keyframe on zoom amount and set it to zero. Then go to the middle where the cut's happening and drag up the zoom amount. Then go to the last frame and drag down the zoom amount back to zero.